welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Mary. Today's topic, just work. His master replied, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful with a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Come and share your master's happiness." His master replied, "You wicked, lazy servant. So you knew that I harvest where I have not sown and gather where I have not scattered seed? Well then, you should have put my money on the deposit with the bankers so that when I return, I would have received it back with interest. So take the bag of gold from him and give it to the one who has 10 bags and throw this worthless servant outside into the darkness where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth." Matthew 25, 21 through to 30. In life, all of us have a purpose. Our purpose may vary, but we all have a purpose nonetheless. There are persons who are more gifted than some. Not everybody is on the same level. Let's be real. If you can preach, there's a more charismatic preacher than you. If you can sing, there's a better singer than you. Whatever you can do, there's always somebody who can do it even better. To be able to function in this earth, God has given us various talents and gifts. Make no mistake about it. What God has given to you is enough for you to fulfill your purpose in the earth. However, many miss the fact that God gives every man according to their ability. There are times when you look at somebody else who may be doing more than you, and it brings a feeling of inadequacy. There are times it will even go a step further and we become envious of the individual. The sooner we accept the fact that there are people who are going to be greater than us, the easier our lives will become. The parable of the talents is quite interesting and quite informative. If we get the message, we understand that we should make the best of what we have and be not concerned about what others have. There are some things that we can learn from this parable. One, the parable teaches us that success is a product of our work. In the book of Genesis, we see that God placed Adam in the garden to work. He was to dress it and take care of it. We were made to work. As Christians, we have a mission that our Lord expects us to accomplish while we are here in this earth. Number two, the talent indicates a large sum of money, maybe as much as even $1 million in today's currency. We are tempted to feel sorry for the servant who received only one talent, but in reality, he received as much as $1 million from the master and he buried it in his backyard. Number three, the parable teaches us that we work for our master and not our own selfish purpose. The money that is given to the servants is not their own. We should maximize the use of our talents, not for our own selfish purpose, but to honor God. Number four, the parable teaches us that we will be held accountable. The unfaithful steward didn't so much waste his master's money, he wasted an opportunity. Whatever you have been called in the kingdom to do, do it. If you have been called to sing, sing. If you have been called to preach, preach. If you have been called to moderate a service, moderate it. If you have been called to be an usher, be an usher. Whatever you have been called to do, fulfill your role and your purpose. The Apostle Peter was concerned about the Apostle John and wanted to know what would become of John. The Lord said to him, "Be not concerned about John, just do the work." So today I'm encouraging you. We might feel discouraged based on some things. Nobody likes to feel less than. Nobody likes to feel as if persons are better than them. However, if you stop focusing on people and start focusing on the work that God has given you to do, it will make things a whole lot better. The quote of the day, God gives every man gifts according to their ability. As you go today, go knowing that you have been fully equipped to fulfill your purpose in this earth. God bless you today, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.